Hi friends, I am Karthik Ravindra Kate and this is Kate Tutorials. In the series of videos, we discussed about liquid water, that is non-aqueous solvent, and also we discussed about non-aqueous solvent like liquid ammonia, and whereas water was aqueous solvent and this liquid ammonia is non-equivalent solvent. We discussed their physical properties, chemical reactions, their structures, everything we have discussed. In this class, I am going to discuss the reactions of liquid sulfur dioxide, that is liquid sulfur dioxide, which is also a non-aqueous solvent. In our discussion, we have only two non-aqueous solvent. One is liquid ammonia. The videos are present in my channel, and the next one is liquid sulfur dioxide. And in this class, I am going to discuss only about its chemical reactions. And in previous class, we discussed that the sulfur dioxide will undergo autoionization, which I have discussed in previous class. That is, one of oxygen moves there to become SO2 plus and the other one become SO3 2 minus. That is nothing but autoionization. And I told you that this SO2 plus acts as acid in liquid sulfur dioxide medium. That is, liquid sulfur dioxide as solvent, if we take this SO2 plus acts as acid, whereas the same SO3 2 minus acts as base, but the condition is in liquid sulfur dioxide. And also in my previous videos, we have discussed that the H plus acts as acid in aqueous solvents like water. In water, H plus acts as acid and OH minus acts as base in water. And also we discussed about NH4 plus. It acts as acid in liquid ammonia, and this NH2 minus acts as base in liquid ammonia, but not in aqueous solvents, that is not in water. These all things we have discussed, and in this class I am going to concentrate only on the reactions. There is no need to explain about these reactions because the same reactions we have studied in this liquid ammonia. First one, acid base reaction. We know that, see, what happens in acid base reaction is, in water medium, H plus acts as acid and OH minus acts as base, and we are going to get water. But it is in water medium, that is aqueous solvent. In the same way, in acid base reaction, in liquid sulfur dioxide, what happens is, see, let me consider an example. SOCl2. Here the SO is SO2 plus, so it acts as acid, and this reacts with Na2SO3, which acts as base because of this SO3 2 minus. I told you SO2 plus acts as acid in liquid sulfur dioxide medium, so it acts as acid, it acts as base, so it is acid base reaction, and the product what I am going to get is nothing but NaCl. See, since it is two molecules, so two molecules of NaCl plus two molecules of SO2 sulfur dioxide. Same thing, if I consider in water medium, as we know that HCl and NOH reacts, what we get? Salt and water, that is NaCl plus H2O, salt and solvent. In the same way, in my liquid sulfur dioxide, I got salt, 2 moles of NaCl and 2 moles of sulfur dioxide, which is nothing but a solvent. That is the beauty of this acid-base reactions in liquid sulfur dioxide. And next case, we shall discuss about redox reaction in liquid sulfur dioxide. So the first one is, I discussed about acid base reaction, and the second one is redox reaction in sulfur dioxide, that is liquid sulfur dioxide, that is non-aqueous solvent. So how redox reaction occurs? We know, no need to tell about redox RE stands for reduction and OX stands for oxidation. So both oxidation and reduction taking place in a same reaction, that is nothing but redox reaction. So we will see how it will occur in sulfur dioxide. Let me consider 6 mole of Ki, potassium iodide, plus 3 molecule of SbCl5, that is antimony pentachloride. Isn't it? Potassium iodide react with antimony pentachloride and the product is, we get SbCl3 antimony trichloride plus 2 molecules of potassium K3 SbCl6, and this is complex, plus I2 iodine we get. So what happens is, this is the good example for redox reaction. See the oxidation of iodine, here potassium is plus 1, so the oxidation of iodine is minus 1. So oxidation of iodine is minus 1. Whereas at the product side, we can see the oxidation state of I2 is nothing but 0. We know that the oxidation of elementary compound is nothing but 0. So from minus 1 to 0, there is increase in oxidation number. So it is oxidation. In this reaction, oxidation of iodine is occurring. Whereas the same SbCl5C, the oxidation of Sb is plus 5 here. Whereas here at the product side, the oxidation of Sb is plus 3 because it is SbCl3. So there is reduction from plus 5 oxidation to plus 3. There is reduction. So iodine is undergoing oxidation, whereas antimony is undergoing reduction. So oxidation and reduction occurring, both are occurring in the same reaction. So it is a good example for redox reaction. But it is occurring in liquid sulfur dioxide. This you should not forget, because the same reaction may not occur in aqueous medium, that is water medium. And the next case is salvolysis reactions. What happens in salvolysis? Nothing but salvo means solvent, lysis means breaking. The breaking of solvent is nothing but salvolysis. We have discussed, I told H2O, here H will break and OH. If this is H2O, I can write H2O like this. H will add to some compound and OH will add to other element. So there is breaking of water. In the same way, we have discussed about ammonia, NH3. I told, if I consider two molecules of ammonia, this ammonia is going to break in such a way that NH2 minus I am going to get, and other case I am going to get NH4 plus, isn't it? So what happens is, this adds to one compound and this adds to other compound. For example, if I consider NaOH, sodium hydroxide, and 2 mole of this ammonia, liquid ammonia, what I get is, see, this Na, NH2, I will get plus NH4OH. Isn't it? So what happens is, this ammonia breaked up, that is lysis, aminolysis we will call it, because ammonia is breaking down. If hydro water is breaking down, it is known as hydrolysis. So it is aminolysis. How it is breaking? NH2 minus and NH4 plus. So we got this product when we reacted with NaOH. And the same reaction in liquid sulfur dioxide, how it occurs, let us see. Let me consider one example, that is, see, PCl5 and SO2. Here sulfur dioxide will break. How it will break? I am going to see like this. It is going to break like this. But the actual structure of sulfur dioxide is like this. S double bond O, double bond O, and there is lone pair of electrons. But for our understanding, I told you that it is lysis. So for best understanding, I am going to show you like this, because it will be good understood. So it is occurring in liquid sulfur dioxide medium. So PCl5 plus SO2, how they are going to form? P POCl3 plus SOCl2. So nothing but the one of the oxygen adds here and other oxygen adds here. This is the reaction occurring in liquid sulfur dioxide, that is the solvolysis. In the same way, let me consider other example like AsCl5 plus SO2. We know that phosphor As, like that, they all comes under same group. So I am considering, instead of phosphor, I am considering As. So AsCl5 plus SO2 in the same liquid sulfur dioxide, what I am going to get? AsOCl3 plus SOCl2. That is the example for solvolysis of sulfur dioxide. And the next class, we shall discuss about metathetical reaction. That is metathetical reactions. I have explained you what are metathetical reactions. If something like we are going to get precipitate in aqueous solvent, we know what happens, the compound will going to settle down. That we call as precipitation, because it is occurring in aqueous solvent. The same precipitation, if it occurs in non-aqueous solvents like sulfur dioxide or like ammonia or like liquid HF, there the same precipitation reactions are called as metathetical reactions. And there is example for metathetical reaction in liquid sulfur dioxide, that is CH3COOAG. Silver salt of acetic acid I considered, plus SOCl2, thionyl chloride. So we know SO2 plus in liquid sulfur dioxide, it acts as acid. It is in liquid sulfur dioxide. So SOCl2, CH3COAG, how they are going to react is they are going to form AgCl. AgCl. 2 moles of AgCl, so I am going to balance like this, plus SOCH3COO twice, isn't it? So what happens, this is nothing but metathetical reaction, because the AgCl is going to be precipitated, that is we are going to get precipitation of AgCl. And we know that if the same AgCl is put in water, it will be soluble. But the same AgCl in liquid sulfur dioxide is insoluble. Insoluble, that is it is undergoing precipitation, and the symbol for precipitation is the arrow mark downside. That is the insoluble and precipitation occurring in sulfur dioxide. Let me give you one more example, KBr, potassium bromide, plus SOCl2 in liquid sulfur dioxide. What happens is we will get KCl plus SOBr twice. We will get, and this KCl undergoes precipitation. It is going to settle down, but only in liquid sulfur dioxide. The same KCl is soluble in aqueous solvent like water, but it is insoluble in liquid sulfur dioxide. See, the reaction is not balanced because 2 Cl are there, but here no. So I will multiply by 2, and here also I will multiply by 2. So now the reaction is balanced. This is about metathetical reaction in liquid sulfur dioxide. Last but not the least, we have one more reaction known as solvation. I have told you before about hydration, isn't it? Hydration, ammoniation. Hydration, see, if CuSO4 is there, if I add water, 5 molecules of water, I am going to get CuSO4 into 5H2O. This is nothing but hydration. In ammonia also we studied, what I considered CuSO4, same salt, but I consider 4 molecules of ammonia and I got CuSO4 into 4H2O. This occurs in water medium, that is aqueous solvent. This occurs in liquid ammonia. Now I am going to give you example for the reaction occurring in liquid sulfur dioxide. So this is occurring in liquid sulfur dioxide. Sodium iodide plus sulfur dioxide. What I am going to get? Sodium iodide into 4SO2. So I am going to consider 4 molecule of sulfur dioxide undergoing solvation with sodium iodide. This is the end of this topic. So if you like these videos, please share with your friends, and if you are not the member of this channel, please be the member of this channel. Thank you.